Yo, 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 what's up, everybody? Welcome back to African Podcast with Ben Real, and this is African Podcast Trending. Wow, wow, I am shocked right now. I'm short of words because just when I thought the saga with Diddy was coming to an end, it took another dimension. Unbelievable dimension, and I'm not gonna even miss a word about this. I think Diddy life is about to experience a downturn. Yeah, I think Diddy's life may be going down from this moment henceforth. We thought this is a lawsuit because the FBI brought 3 charges against him. He might probably hire a good lawyer. Maybe 1 or 2 of those charges may be dropped. But hell no. Because right now, the news making the round is that Puff Diddy, the one and only Sean Combs, just racked up another 120 lawsuits. And this is not funny at all. So, from what we gather, Diddy is moving from one trouble to another as another lawyer, a well-known lawyer in person of Anthony. His name is Tony Busby. Yo, this guy came on hard on Diddy today, yo. And I just want to play what he said so you guys can at least have a first-hand news from the man who seems he's all ready to make Diddy life even more difficult than it already is. Take a listen.
The biggest secret in the entertainment industry that really wasn't a secret at all has finally been revealed to the world. The wall of silence has now been broken and victims are coming forward. Our team has had at this point more than 3,285 individuals contact us with people claiming to have been victimized by Sean Combs.
Lord Jesus.
After vetting, we now represent 120 individuals who intend to bring civil claims in civil court against Sean Diddy Combs, as well as claims against many other individuals and entities that we will name as defendants as we file these individual cases. And you should know, to the extent the clients feel comfortable, we also intend to make these individuals available to the authorities, specifically to the FBI. And you should also know a few of them have already been spoken to by the FBI. Now, before we discuss the nature of the claims and claimants themselves, let me comment on the large volume of calls we have received since our first announcement. Even before the indictment of Sean Combs, we had received a small volume of calls and it screened a handful of cases. After the indictment of Sean Combs and the announcement that we were pursuing these claims, the floodgates opened. People who wouldn't otherwise, for a variety of reasons, are now stepping forward to make their voices heard and to pursue justice. The biggest secret in the entertainment industry that really wasn't a secret at all has finally been revealed to the world. People claiming to have been victimized by Sean Combs. After vetting, we now represent 120 individuals who intend to bring civil claims in civil court against Sean Diddy Combs, as well as claims against...
All right. Yeah, you heard it, guys. After vetting, Busby said they now have 120 clients who's ready to testify against Diddy and possibly go after his millions. I guess the last time when I checked, Diddy is worth $600 million. Yeah, I think that's what I found when I look at
new allegations today of sexual assault.
So when I checked Celebrity World, he's worth $600 million. You know the way it is, like, once these black dudes, they started catching cases, their net worth dropped drastically. We used to think Diddy was actually a billionaire, although I read somewhere, I think I read it from Still, the Celebrity Network, somebody said Diddy was never a billionaire. But, you know, there's nothing to prove that or to justify the saying. But from what I saw on paper, he's worth $600 million. Now, if we say these ladies that are coming out to file lawsuit against Diddy are actually coming for a payout, that would be injustice to those ladies. Because if you go by all the horrible stuff we heard about, the free calls, the baby oils and everything, and if you saw, if you watch any video of an actual victim describing what it was like being in Diddy's world, you definitely know that these go ways beyond money. Okay, I know the compensation might be large, you know. You might say, oh hell no, that number of people, 120 people coming after just one person, they are lying. No, I don't think so, because if you live in the world of entertainers, you will understand that people truck to their party in numbers, in numbers. And if there is any proof that that much number of people actually showed up, I think the 1,000 baby oil should do the magic. Well, everything, all accused of, all allegations against Diddy so far, they are all allegedly, like I've always said on this platform, no one is guilty until proven guilty in the court of law. So we're going to take it all on the assumption that maybe Diddy's lawyer might start taking these cases apart and actually get him a reduced sentence. Here is more news from the 120 lawsuit.
And exploitation by Combs. For the first time, we are hearing about victims who say they were minors when they were allegedly assaulted by the music star. The youngest allegedly just 9 years old. The allegations were revealed today by attorneys representing more than 100 alleged victims who are preparing to sue. So let's bring in NBC News entertainment correspondent Chloe Malas right now. So Chloe, we know there is currently a press conference underway. We do have live picture of that. Can you just walk us through these new allegations and tell us if we've heard from Combs yet?
So the individual that you see on the screen right now, that is an attorney based out of Houston, Texas, and his name is Tony Busby. He's been a part of some very well-known litigation over the years involving a BP oil spill, even involving the Astroworld Music Festival crisis where some individuals were killed during a stampede. So he has made headlines.
Now, let me tell you something, guys. Let me tell you something. You see, in Texas, you don't want to be in the crosshair of any lawyer. Texas lawyers aren't playing. When they come for you, they're coming for you. These folks, these big law firms, they deal with oil cases, oil companies. So they got the resources and everything to go after anybody. So I really don't see how this is going to work in favor of Diddy. All we can do right now, as a black brother, we can just pray for him.
Before, but this is pretty shocking. So he claims at this, is claiming right now at this press conference, that he has had over 3,000 individuals reach out to his law firm in Houston, Texas, that he and his team have been vetting these claims, that now they are representing over 120 accusers, and that over the next 30 days, they will begin to file different civil suits. That this is not a class action lawsuit, that they are going to continue to vet these allegations. But right now they feel strong about these. So he also said today that it's not just Combs that will be named as
the biggest secret in the entertainment industry.
New allegations today of sexual.
Let me take a couple of comments here, guys.
The biggest secret in the entertainment.
New allegations today.
So, King, is that King? What's the name? I think it's King. So, King said, charge the other celebrities too. Well, let me see what the reply is like, because that actually got over 23,000 likes. And when Kiki said, charge the other celebrities too, Diana replied and said, Jay-Z is worse. Proof? Victims? This person said, he's literally Diddy's best friend. Jay-Z is just as responsible as Diddy because he knew everything and never said anything. I shake my head. Eddie said, Diddy has more lawsuits than hit songs. That's funny, dude. Come on. And Joshua Campbell said, 9 years old, everyone did his list who was here, and Diddy himself need to be legally executed. Wow. I think people are just angry, man. Demetri said, bro, how does everything keep getting worse every single day? I don't know, bro. I don't know how Diddy got himself so deep into this mess that every day is like we wake up to a brand new hit song from Diddy, and this ain't your kind of music that you want to hear. These are bad news, and bad news about Diddy is beginning to sound like music. I don't know how things keep on getting worse for Diddy. But let's see, maybe someone else can tell us.
This is just crazy. Just read.
New audio has surfaced as part of a lawsuit that accuses Christian Holmes, Sean Diddy Combs' son, of sexual assault.
The fall of Sean Diddy Combs has been nothing short of monumental. And what's coming out now is even more jaw-dropping than anyone could have imagined. It's not just the A-listers or business partners turning their backs on him. It's his own family. Yes, you heard that right. Jeez. Diddy's own sons have reportedly made a deal with the FBI, spilling details that could seal the fate of their once powerful father. These aren't just vague whispers anymore. As the investigation unfolds, the role Diddy's sons played in his downfall is coming into focus, and the web of connections is more twisted than we ever thought.
This has to be a 100% culture shock. I can't imagine living.
Diddy's arrest was a seismic event that sent shockwaves through the entertainment world.
I don't believe this one. I'm sorry. I really don't believe this one. FBI reveals Diddy's son made a deal and betrayed their father. I don't believe this one. I think somebody is trying to make something up here. Let me take a couple of comments. King said, it's so many lies. No one knows what to believe, which is good. Let me alter it. Diddy got Biggie mother period. Oh, wow. I don't know. And he said, I think no doubt to them what to do. Yeah. And Ivy said, they don't have the right to blame their father. They need to pay for their involvement themselves. Well, like I say, I really don't believe this story. Let me just move on to the next.
Florida woman is the latest to file a string of sexual assault lawsuits against Sean Diddy Combs. The woman, who is listed as Jane Doe on the complaint filed Friday, says she was repeatedly raped and drugged by Diddy for 4 years, starting in 2020. She says she became pregnant after one of their encounters and that she later suffered a miscarriage. Combs remains behind bars on federal sex trafficking charges. He has pleaded not guilty. Florida woman is the late.
Is this ever going to stop? Another Florida woman? Okay, that makes it 121 lawsuits. I'm just going to keep counting it like that. Let me just keep counting, yo.
Young Miami is named in this lawsuit. There is a Jane Doe that has sued Diddy. and says that Diddy raped her, allegedly, and drugged her, allegedly. Also forced her to have an abortion, allegedly.
Oh,
this was
boy.
Months after. She said the rape took place in 1 month, and a few months later, she was pregnant. He forced her to get rid of the baby, and even had Young Miami call her
really?
And force her to get rid of the baby because she was next to get pregnant. I've already allowed baby love to have a baby, but you ain't finna have no baby with Diddy. Not today, bitch. I'm next. And so allegedly Young Miami called up the bitch and said, you have got to get rid of that baby. And due to the stress, she had a miscarriage. And so, but she's suing Diddy for, you know, drugging with her, enforced abortion, all types of shit, right? She's hoping to get it back. But, you know, Carisha's career has took a really bad hit. Carisha has crashed.
Okay.
So much so I'm looking at her podcast numbers and I'm like, you got Tia Kemp on your podcast. You got Rick Ross on your podcast.
Okay. I ain't taking anyone. That's coming from Tasha K. And you know, Tasha like to hear the bad news, and sometimes you don't even know where her news is coming from. But anyway, the point we're making tonight is Diddy got tons of lawsuits to deal with, and I feel really sorry for him. I hope he gets a good lawyer and he can get out of this mess he dug himself into. Now, guys, let me know what you think in the comment. Do you think this 120 lawsuit will stand? Or do you think people are just trying to cash out and take advantage of the situation the music legend is right now? Let me know what you think in the comment. This is Uncle Ben, and this is Trending with Benno.